For those passing the Donington Manor restaurant on the A21 at Dunton Green near SEVENOAKS for the first time, there's no doubting it. A splendid 15th century manor house, complete with loopy roof, low ceilings and a forest of beams. In fact, a charming picture postcard slice of Middle Age England. Also, the man who bought it in 1971 believed when he instructed his architects to knock it down so he could extend the hotel he was building next door.
Then we got in touch with the local fuddy-duddies, the Dunton Green, and they in turn got in touch with the Ministry of the Environment, I presume, and within days I had a learned man come down and went through the building and told me it was 500 years old and gave me a fantastic history, and I'm sure he felt it was correct. I didn't argue about it. I accepted it and I thought, well, disaster. My plans have been completely demolished.
But having retained it, spent £3,000 eradicating dry rot, not to mention the fortune it still cost to heat the place, Mr. Powett, seems, may have been the victim of an entirely innocent and masterful fraud. Because according to a local historian, Fergus Ancorn, this is what Donington Manor looked like back in 1929. A couple of very ordinary humdrum farm cottages, subsequently Tudorised by an eccentric local builder just 46 years ago in 1938. Locals we spoke to today gave the same story, but despite our efforts, neither they nor Mr. Ancorn were ready to substantiate their claim in front of the camera. Meanwhile, Mr. Powell finds himself in a quandary. If the house can be proved to be a con, should he knock it down, thus saving on all those maintenance costs? Or does he perpetuate the myth of age, including the claim in his own publicity leaflet that the Earl of Surrey slept here while on his way to sign a treaty with Louis XII of France? In the event, he says, it's the food that counts. Besides, unless the files at the local trading standards office date back 400 years or more, who's going to prove otherwise? Stephen Chambers at Dunton Green for Thames News.